Good morning. Thanks for tuning in and welcome to a new trading week. The local share market, according to the futures, is expected to kick off in positive territory this morning. Important to bear in mind that the SPY futures contract last traded Saturday morning local time, and at that point it was up by around 0.4%. There's been a lot go on in the bigger picture since then, which we'll get to in a moment. But in terms of what the tone of things was at the conclusion of the US session again on Saturday morning, we had markets end with quite encouraging gains on Friday. So the Dow Jones was up 0.9%, the S&P 500 rose by 1.2%, and the NASDAQ was up by 1.6%. So these gains, you could reasonably say, are counterintuitive under the circumstances, given the fact that the September non-farm payrolls report, the jobs report on Friday, which was much anticipated, came in with a very hot headline number. There were far more jobs created in the US economy in the month of September compared to what most economists had forecast. So that figure, in terms of the average of forecasts, centered on a figure of 170,000 jobs. What you actually saw was 336,000 jobs added to the economy. So much more than what the market was looking for. The unemployment rate was steady at 3.8%. And you might well ask, how is it that you could see concerns in the market about a hot jobs market and then have stocks finish higher to the extent that they did? So that is actually a challenging point to rationalize. So what do we know? We at least know that the wages component of this jobs report was just below the market's expectations. So the month-on-month wage increase was a little bit lower than expected. The annualized pace of wage growth, according to this report, was came in at 4.2%. So that was below the rate of 4.3% that the market was looking for. It's a thin argument, but nonetheless, you saw the initial response. So in the first instance following these numbers, you actually saw US stocks sell off quite meaningfully. And then at the same time, you saw US interest rates push higher by a substantial margin as well. At the high of the session, you had the 10-year Treasury note at its highest level in around 16 years, just short of 4.9%, 4.88%. There was a bit of a moderation towards the end of the day with the yields coming down. A 10-year Treasury note finished at around 4.79%. It was still up by 8 basis points, and a 2-year up by about 6 points, so 5.08%. Again, we find ourselves trying to rationalize how the market behaved under these circumstances. The other point that you would make is that over the course of the last month or so, you have seen a very substantial pullback where stocks are concerned. On average, you've seen major stock indices down by about 7%. In the case of the MSCI, the Morgan Stanley Capital Index, it's down by about 7% over the course of the last month. So a big retrenchment in prices. And under the circumstances of what we saw on Friday, that seemed to be enough for the moment. And in the same breath, you would have to talk about the very substantial retreat where interest rates have been concerned. Just over the course of last week alone, for example, a 10-year Treasury note off by about 22 basis points. So this, for the moment, has created a bit of a moat around prices. It is just a question of whether or not the markets reflect on the strength of these numbers on Friday over the weekend, come back with fresh eyes this week. You would have to say that within that stream of thought, you've got two very important outcomes later on in the week. You've got consumer price figures and producer prices in the US. Markets could potentially be less forgiving if you see some heat in those figures under these circumstances. So that's the thing to look out for, of course. Elsewhere, there have been some very grim developments as far as the Middle East is concerned. Tragic outcomes in terms of the cost of human life, but at the risk of being indelicate, markets quickly form calculations on the basis of these types of conflicts. And the first thing that will be thought about is what this means as far as Middle Eastern energy security is concerned, what it means in terms of the provision of energy products coming out of that very important jurisdiction. So given the fact that you have seen oil prices pull back quite substantially over the course of the last week, at the peak, you have seen them trading closer to $95 a barrel, where West Texas Intermediate crude oil is concerned. We saw prices on Friday finish quite a deal lower compared to that benchmark, so closer to $83 a barrel in the case of WTI. So it's now a question, given everything that's happened at the weekend, whether or not you get a risk premium built into oil prices, given the conflict in the Middle East. Last day in Israel, which is a working day in Israel, their weekend starts on Friday, Saturday, Sunday is a trading day on the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange. You had the index there down by about 7.5%. And so that is an indication of the unease in that particular market. It's a market that is heavily skewed towards technology. So it's all always a matter of trying to estimate second and third order consequences when it comes to these types of markets. So at the very least, you could see a flight to some safety. The US dollar could be supported under these circumstances. You could see government bonds of a higher quality in these sorts of jurisdictions come into slightly higher demand under these circumstances. There's a lot of uncertainty given what's happened, and trying to estimate, as I said, those third and fourth order consequences. So that's the thing that we'll be keeping an eye on as we move through the early part of Asian trade, to see if there are any unwelcome knock-on effects. But certainly, probably the first port of call will be keeping a very close eye on how energy products behave over the course of the next couple of days. So having said all of that, as I said, the SPY futures pointing to a gain of around 0.4%. And you would reasonably expect that those energy stocks on the ASX would be under very close scrutiny today. So keep an eye out on those. The Aussie dollar, under the circumstances of those stronger employment figures in the US, interestingly enough, has been, it's back to around 63.6 US cents, but the US dollar index actually fell, strangely enough, over the course of the session on Friday. So again, counterintuitive responses to that very strong jobs number. But again, you would be looking at this in the context of this entire week, with those consumer and producer inflation numbers at the end of the week quite vital in terms of the trajectory of these markets at the moment.